You're responsible for some of the finest examples of the action genre in recent years. What for you is the essence of good action, and how does Bullet Train emphasize that?
The essence of good action is character. And I think you have to define the character in the action and make sure that you're learning in sequence to sequence and you know, having them arc in those moments. I think this is a perfect example. Like, every one of these characters not only has a different style of fighting that defines who they are, but is dealing with different emotional journeys and stakes-driven journeys that are punctuated with the action. So without that, action is meaningless, really. Spectacle, yeah, trailer moment, cool, but it doesn't drive the story forward.
We got it from Sony for David to direct, and I read it, and it was just so wildly modern and original, and, you know, David's the type of filmmaker who gets to do those shots, and the trick was, you know, who plays Ladybug, and that challenged us for a really long time, and not that long, actually, but to the point where it was like, do we go to Brad? Like, that's a scary, you know, pursuit, because he's so busy, and, you know, we'd never gone to him before, and it's like, you know, all this history, and it's a little daunting. And then he read it in a weekend and was like, Leitch, I'm in! And then it became a movie. It was beautiful, actually. David brought it to the next level. He brought a lot of pathos, a lot of heart. He wanted to make sure that you connected to every character along the way in an emotional way. And it, I think that's probably what brought it to the next level. And then the players, starting with Brad, wanted to add comedy and wit and charm. And they did it in spades. And I think that combination is just lethal.
You know, their performances helped elevate it. You know, you've trapped to, in these movies that have such broad comedy, you still have to find those moments of pathos. And you look at Brian, Tyree Henry, and Aaron Taylor Johnson, Joey King, like the level of talent we were playing with, like they could play the nuances and deliver real feels in the middle of this crazy movie. It's really easy with these people. I mean, they're all professionals, and it starts with Brad. He's such a giving actor. I think it's always been a giving actor, but you know, his years in the business and working with the best, he knows he's got to support the younger talent and lead from example, and he's so giving.
And
he
so
sets
is
it.
David as a director. He fosters a really warm environment that you know, best idea wins, and I think that allows them all to play in a way that, you know, kind of becomes a bit of magic.
With John Wick and now with Ladybug, you've created these instant icons of the screen. I'm curious if you can talk about what's so special about what Brad did with Ladybug, and if we're ever going to see those two icons clash heads on screen, because that would be something special.
You know, I think Ladybug's you know, power of luck is undeniable. So yeah, it might be really fun. Be a really fun fantasy, and I'm sure they'll explore it somewhere on the internet.
Hopefully John doesn't have a pencil. Thanks.
Well, it wasn't a lot of work, honestly. David put us together for a chemistry read. I think Aaron was attached first, and then he asked me to come along. And he put us together in a room, and it was all downhill from there. No, it was amazing, man. I mean, Aaron is such an amazing actor, man. He's a dreamboat. You can't deny him. He's like, he gives this rough exterior, but there's a gooey center in there that I'm able to, like, pull out. And,
yeah. Only you allowed to see that. You see.
Only
that's only
to say
for you.
That too. But yeah, man, he's just a great guy to work with.
Yeah,
and I mean,
likewise,
it's very rare,
man,
that you get that opportunity to play with someone like that.
You working with Brian?
Oh my gosh, I'm a huge fan of his. I was an admirer of his work. And then, like, I didn't know who Tangerine was until Brian stepped into the shoes of Lemon. And when he did, I knew it was just like instantaneously going to be magic, and there was going to be a bond for life. I love this guy, yeah. And I think we created something that we're really proud of. I mean, this was a lot of fun.
Yeah, it's brilliant.
I think these two have such a strong bond and an empathy for one another. They don't have empathy for anybody else because
yeah,
they're psychopaths, but they love each other, you know. And so there's this beautiful codependency that they have, and this lovely sort of back and forth banter, like a yin and yang kind of vibe.
Yeah.
They're partners in crime. So when you see them sort of split up, you really want to root for them that they can get through
get
this train
together.
Journey,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah, for sure.
You are literally taking turns beating up Brad Pitt in this film. Who do you think did the best job, and what was the most fun part of that experience for you guys?
I love the fight sequence these two did in the quiet car, you know, and also it was one of the first action scenes we shot at the beginning of the movie, so they set the bar really high. And it comes across really brilliantly, man.
Yeah, my favorite was two things. I got to slap his head into a table, take after take. And I also got my nuts hit a bunch of times by Brad Pitt, which was actually not in the choreo. That was just his suggestion. But it was really good. It was really fun. He's one of the most generous actors to work with. And I feel grateful to be able to do this with him.
Ryan, I have to say, as a Brit, your accent was incredible to the point where I couldn't tell. And did Aaron have a play in this?
I didn't need to give him any tips, man.
All I wanted was dual citizenship. So if you guys can give me that, then I think I can pass over here. That's great. No, I had a really great dialect coach. Jameson Bryant came on, was there every day, making sure I was doing my drills. I wanted to make sure it was as authentic as possible because I didn't want any of you meeting me in a corner somewhere being like, you were shit. So I did everything I could, and I love Lemon. He was on the page as being British. So I wanted to keep them that way. We got out of the house. We got to make a movie like this that was incredible on the page. It was brilliantly written and directed by David Leitch. And it was really, really fun to just like fight Brad Pitt every day. It really was. My thing would be technology, so I'd like to like go through his phone so I can blackmail him at some point if he ever gets in the way. No, I don't know. I think he's his own superhero in his own way, and he brings that out of us in the film. And it's really great to be elevated by somebody like Brad.
Can you tell us, for people who haven't seen the film, a little bit more about Prince and how fun it was tormenting this A-list cast?
The Prince is pretty awesome because when we first meet her, she really uses her innocent look and her schoolgirl looks to distract and disguise her evil mind. And she uses her manipulation to kind of orchestrate a lot of terrible stuff and loves it.
You're an incredible actress, and your character was an incredible actress, and she used her powers for bad. Yeah. Have you ever been tempted to use your acting prowess to get something that you wanted?
Honestly, I do not know how to frickin' lie to save my life. It is so embarrassing. Like, I have given away birthday presents on accident because I can't keep it in. I'm like, I was getting my fiance a birthday present one time, and I was like looking at my phone. He's like, "What are you doing?" I was like, "Nothing." Like, I give myself away so quickly. So no, even if I wanted to, I couldn't.
It's an absolute pleasure to have you with us in London, looking even more handsome than usual. Can you talk to us a bit about Ladybug? He's a very interesting guy, and I'm curious if you share his... I'm curious if you share his obsession with fate and good luck or not.
Yeah, he's... Do I share it? I hope I'm a little more grounded than our friend Ladybug. But he is on his mindfulness journey, and we wish him the best.
And you've worked with a lot of great casts, but you've never really beaten them up quite as much as this. Can you talk about that?
Nor got beaten up as much. The boys were like having far too much fun, I gotta say. It's questionable.
All of the characters are morally questionable, and I wondered how much fun you had.
Yeah, they are.
Did you have a lot of fun exploring the different facets of Ladybug's personality?
Well, that was the thing. When I read the script, like, every character had something going on. They had their own agenda, which means we're going to get a great cast, which means at the end of the day, everyone gets a score. It is really, really funny. They are really, really funny.
And your preparation, can you share with us a little bit how you prepare?
I wish. This one didn't require that much. This was kind of let's show up and let's make it up as we go. Yeah, and have a laugh.
You're a performer with quite a sharp eye for comic timing. No worries. Was that something that you enjoyed leaning into in this film?
Yeah, probably like when you get older, like it's just more fun, man. Just more fun than like sobbing and moaning. But this one I read like in the heart of lockdown, and it just made me laugh, and I thought, oh, thank God, this is what I need. I imagine a few other people are going to enjoy this too. You know, I like to mix it up, and I love film, I love the shows, and I like bouncing around between them all. Yeah.
You're a legend, right? You're an A-lister, everyone expects to see you leading a role. However, in Deadpool 2, you were in it for 3 seconds. And then film, the same man returned the favor. So how did that come about? And are we going to see like a back and forth?
Yeah, you know, there's a few other surprises, like some cameos that drop in it. And Sandy and I were able to like, you know, jump in each other's film. And that was really fun. I like this idea of cross-pollinating each other's stuff. It's a great community. A lot of us are friends and just pulling together, like I like this.
So it's been
I want
a favor.
More of that.
Yeah.
the fight scenes with the boys were really funny, I gotta say. They were fun to do, because it was more this Jackie Chan element, you know, if I could compare ourselves to the great, the god, the one and only. But it was cool. We were to be in that slipstream.
This film is incredible. It's full of fast-paced action, but it's unique in the sense of its sense of humor, and it's not quite an action film. It's not quite a comedy. Like, how would you explain the genre?
I would go action comedy, yeah. But it's also original, so which is rare in the theater these days. It's not a franchise or anything. Well, it may be now, right? Never mind.